Well, he has all the answers to those really weird and wacky questions that have been plaguing us since the dawn of time. It's Australia's president of science. Let's welcome back to Studio 10, Dr. Karl. Yes, please, yes. Dr. Karl.
Good morning,
Dr. President Karl.
Well, I'm not worthy, but thank you. She leaves that to Doctor Who.
Talk to us, Dr. Karl. Is there any truth to the 5-second rule?
Remarkably little.
Okay. And just to explain, the 5-second rule is when you drop something on the floor and then eat it.
Yeah.
Because so, I always with you know, God made dirt, so dirt didn't hurt.
Dirt didn't hurt. Food poisoning can kill. About 3,000 people die from it every year.
Wow.
So do we have any cavernosy sausage here?
Yes, yes,
so if you,
we do.
So if you get some of this nice sausage here and then cut into a slice, and if you drop it onto a hard surface like that, within 5 seconds, 99% of the bacteria have moved across. Onto a soft surface like fabric, only a few percent will go across in 5 seconds. But the point is the bacteria go across.
Can I demonstrate?
When you say
go ahead.
Go
oh, my God, in reality, okay. Dropping.
So, ready?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh. One,
right,
so
good contact.
Two, three, four, five.
All the bacteria gone across now.
Okay.
What do you mean by that? The bacteria's gone
step
across.
Two.
The bacteria migrate from the floor onto the sausage. Now, in most cases, it doesn't do anything bad to you, but in America, you have about 50 million cases of food poisoning a year. A couple of 100,000 go to hospital, 3,000 die, and I had a friend who turned into a jellyfish.
Oh, my goodness. So in terms John of... put that on his
let me explain, right?
What was the last bit?
A friend turned into a jellyfish.
Yeah.
Oh. So what happened was they got food poisoning. Their immune system made antibodies to fight the food poisoning bacteria, and they got better.
Right.
But by a terrible coincidence, those antibodies attacked her hip joints, knee joints, ankle joints, shoulder joints, elbow joints, heading into the finger joints now, all from food poisoning. Mm. So, yes, it's good to have a strong immune system, and a bit of dirt doesn't hurt, but the way to get a strong immune system is with eat food, not too much, mostly plants, and get good sleep and do exercise, and don't get your food, your immune system from eating off
one
the
quick
floor.
Question, Dr. Karl.
Oh, you've been
Could you have told me this before I ate the sausage?
Yeah.
You're the experimental animal. You're the warm prop. You're disposable. I'm sorry. It's Dr. Russell.
No, I wanted to ask about worms. I mean, there's this sort of idea that we don't have worms anymore and that actually might be a bad thing.
There's definitely a link. This is a whole different thing that's not mentioned in my fabulous new book, but it's about worms, where in societies where you do have lots of worms, the incidence of asthma and various other diseases is a lot lower.
Mm.
Yes, but we're still better off in our society without the worms. But there are some cases where people live in our society and can be fixed by these worms. And so what you do is people eat the worms, they then poo them out, wash them, and then put them into a little sealed bottle and then sell them around the world.
Incredible.
Yuck. Dr. Karl, the paleo diet, which is very popular now, is it true that it's linked back to our ancestors?
Kind of. In 1977, somebody said that our ancestors were carnivores, which is wrong, and they had only meat, which is wrong, and therefore we should eat only meat with a little tiny bit of vegetable and a bit of fat. And year in, year out, with all of the nutrition surveys, they test the top fad diets. The paleo diet always comes down near the worst, down near the bottom.
Why?
And the weird thing about the diet industry, it's the only industry that fails with this product 95% of the time. It does fabulously well every single year. So we've got, so here you've got some meat, which is good, and the broccoli, which is good. Oh, they're the legumey things. They're considered bad. So they say that you shouldn't have the grains or the dairy or the legumes or the potato or the processed oils. And I love olive oil.
So why is this a bad diet?
For a few reasons. From a nutritional point of view, the dietitians hate it because it gives you a very unbalanced bunch of foods. You miss out on your grains and your dairy, which are part of a well-balanced diet which then integrates with the bacteria in your gut. And what they're saying is just eat this very narrow diet and miss out on the beautiful olive oil. And all the dietitians around the world, year after year, it's the worst diet.
Or the beautiful naturally occurring cabana.
That's grown off the cabana
sugar
tree.
Sugar is good for you, that's what I reckon.
In small quantities, and for birthday cakes.
Yeah,
I love
it. We're all obsessed with selfies.
Yes.
Aren't we? But where did it come from?
On the 13th of September in the year 2002, a guy called Nathan Hope posted a little document about how he'd put his teeth through his lower lip and needed some stitches. And then he posted what he called a self photograph, and he said at 3:19 p.m. on the 13th of September 2002, he said, "Sorry about the focus, comma, it was a selfie," and that was the very first written use of the word selfie anywhere in the known universe, and guess whose homepage it was on?
Whose?
Mine.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Yeah, I helped a little bit, and in 2013 it became the most popular word of the year in the Oxford English Dictionary.
Wow. So another great Australian invention, the black box, the Hills hoist, the cochlear implant and the selfie.
Wi-Fi and the selfie.
Two of them weren't Australian inventions. I'm sorry, I'm a bummer, I'm a downer, man.
Don't go up against the big brain.
The black box was already in use in America. Mm-hmm. What was the next one you mentioned?
I'm sorry, I said anything.
The cochlear implant is Australian, the other one?
Wi-Fi?
The Hills hoist?
The Hills hoist was already in use across America, but it was just popularised here. I'm sorry.
Dr. Karl, everyone, fascinating story. And Dr. Karl has a brand new book. You always do the very, very best titles for books. House of Karls.
Yeah. Very good.
It's available at all good bookstores, so make sure you pop out and grab it. Thanks so much, Dr. Karl, for coming in. All right, well, Angela Bishop opens up the Showbiz File on the other side of the break. You're watching Studio 10. Don't go anywhere.